reason that you had to care. The traffic is stuck and you're not moving anywhere. You thought you found a friend to take you out of this place. Someone you could lend a hand in return for grace. It's a beautiful.
Welcome back to CBTV. I'm Kirk.
And I'm Ariana. We are the CBTV anchors. We have no birthdays to celebrate today.
Here is last week's Throwback Thursday picture. The person in the picture is Ms. Pope. Congratulations, Jordan and Ms. Murphy class, for guessing correctly. Please come to the studio after CBTV for your prize.
Next, we have the question of the week. How many pints are in a gallon? Please return all answers into the orange box in Mr. Thompson's room. The winner will be picked this Friday. Next, let's turn to Jack for this week in sports.
This weekend in the Circle City saw lots of basketball by hosting the Big Ten tournament. Michigan State won the championship game on Sunday. Five other Big Ten teams have found a place in the men's NCAA basketball tournament. They are Michigan, Wisconsin, Ohio State, Iowa, and Nebraska. I look forward to sharing the tournament with you in the next couple of weeks. Also, this past Saturday, our Indiana Pacers rallied from 25 points down to beat the Pistons in Detroit. The Colts made some moves this past weekend by signing the former New York Giant wide receiver Hakeem Nicks to a one-year contract. I'm Jack, and this has been your Weekend in Sports. Back to you, anchors.
This weekend, Indianapolis hosts Comic-Con. Comic-Con is a convention that brings in many comic books. Collectors and sport hero fans, if you found yourself downtown this weekend standing next to Spider-Man and Captain America, Comic-Con is the reason why. This convention brought in thousands of fans on Saturday. The convention center had to turn away thousands of fans because the room was too filled with capacity. This was a good sign for years to come. The organizers stated that more space would be needed for next year.
Next, we have Today in History. On this day in 1941, the National Gallery of Art was officially opened by the U.S. President Franklin D. Roosevelt in Washington, D.C.
Our thought of the day comes from famous jazz musician Nat King Cole, who was born on this day in 1919. He said, "I may be helping to bring harmony between people through my music."
Next, we would like to wish our third graders good luck on the IRE test this week. We know all of you will do great.
Thank you for listening. I'm Ariana.
And I'm Kurt. Have a great Monday.
Take care of yourself and stay responsible, respectful, and safe.